Hey, Tubes. Gonna be doing a little cleaning on the 1050 today. Sorry, sound a little goofy. Just got off a pretty bad, still getting off a pretty bad cold here. Had a little ambition today. Thought I'd clean it up. Something to do. Make a video. What the heck? Why not? So here we go. Anyway. Toolbox is full of junk. We're gonna vacuum that out and do a little cleaning, make a stupid video. Down and dirty, why not? I don't think that turned out too bad. Still shows a little dirt, but I'll clean it up. See what happens from there. Stay tuned. Enough, I say. Sorry, I'd be talking more in the video, but for those of you that aren't aware, I've been pretty sick here this last week, so it's pretty hard for me to talk, so it's gonna be a pretty quiet video. I think it's pretty self-explanatory. Probably the first time I've ever done a silent video. Which is alright, because we don't care about me talking anyway, we just want to see the work getting done. Basically what I'm doing here is I'm pushing the door molding on to seat the adhesive. I guess there's adhesive inside this. And 29 Chevy recommend putting this on to keep the seat pan from cutting into the material. So that's what I'm doing here. Excuse me. I guess I might as well add, since I'm talking, what I did before was I took isopropyl alcohol and I wiped off all the edges so that the glue would stick. And then I used a dry rag behind the isopropyl alcohol to wipe off the alcohol residue. It's kind of an important step. Black paint I put on there to protect the weld. The seat pan was cracked, obviously. I think it turned out pretty well myself. Didn't have any magic paint, but obviously you're not going to see it. With the seat cover on there, it's going to protect it and keep it from rusting. I think it looks pretty damn good. Got the seat cover over there in the sun warming up. Should be nice and pliable. Excuse me. Let's see if we can make this happen today. I don't see why not. Do you?